Hey guys, in the following video, this is the movie that I'm talking about, The Editor, released by Scream Factory. There you go. I realize I did not mention it once in the following video, so this is The Editor that I'm talking about. And I got it for a Secret Santa at work. Thanks, Moesis. And, here's the impromptu review. Hey guys, my name is Max. Welcome to my movie channel. Waiting for Chinese food right now in the car. And I showed you earlier on in this video that we were going to watch The Editor, me and Kevin, and we did. And, you know, I went into it with the,
We're the White Hodge twins.
Yeah. We've been intermittent fasting today. We just went to the range, shooting range, too. My shoulder hurts from my new 12 gauge, but it's fucking... Ooh, it's great. Excuse me. Anyways, but last night, we watched The Editor, and I went into it thinking that it was just a regular horror movie, and it wasn't. It was like horror comedy. Kevin, what did you do? Because we didn't know anything about this before we saw the movie. Just your thoughts.
I still have to look up the plot. I don't understand it.
Yeah, that's...
It was. I think it was all in the guy's head. That's what I think. Mm. It was kind of like a Fight Club thing.
Fight Club thing? I didn't even think about that. That's a pretty good possibility, dude.
Because remember, they had that part where they said that he set out to film like a never-ending movie. You remember that?
Yeah. Yeah, he did. They did say that. And this film could have gone on forever. Thank God it didn't, though. Because it was very confusing, and I'm not sure what was going on. There's
your separate... father is a strange man.
Yeah. we'll hit you with some quotes from the movie. Your father's a strange man. Better you hear it from someone who cares about you. Okay? Like, but the way it was just, they were talking about something totally different and he just says that. Another one was two naked men because they were taking it not together, but it was in an area where there was a community shower. Walks up, and they're close, and they're eye to eye. Then the one guy looks down, looks up, and smiles like this, and says, "You have a nice penis." And we were just like, "Man, what the fuck is going on in this movie, man? What's going on in this movie?"
I said that in the first 10 minutes. I was like, "What am I watching?
What am I watching?" Now, in the beginning of the movie, you remember that guy in the beginning of the movie where we think it's actually going to be the movie? That was actually scary, the dude's voice. It sounded like,
Yeah, and they never even revealed I guess it was the wife was the killer. It's such a weird movie.
Yeah,
If you guys know, if you've seen Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas, imagine that, but without the drugs. That's the movie. It was that without any kind of drugs. They didn't need drugs. It was just fucking weird.
I never saw that movie before, Fear and Loathing. I know I'm going to get, people are going to be like, what?
It's another one that you don't understand.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense.
Yeah. I know Johnny Depp's in it. That's really all I know about it. But this movie, The Editor, is very strange. I mean, but it was still pretty good. But don't go into it expecting a horror movie. It's definitely a comedy horror movie. It came out in 2015. It's a Canadian film, by the way, Kevin, I found out. Canadian film, mate.
Shot in Italian fashion.
Shot in an Italian fashion, very true. A lot of Dario Argento-inspired shots in this movie. And it's all right, bro. Here's another one. Tell them about that dude.
It's weird because I didn't understand it. Yeah. But I don't feel like I wasted my time watching it. It's a weird movie. I don't know. It was like a story, an adventure.
It wasn't bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was all right, man. And Kevin does the best impression of the inspector. Okay, let's tell you one thing. It's not really a spoiler, but there's one part where this guy, and there's a lot of nudity in this film. I didn't know that before we watched it.
Yeah, don't watch it with your kids.
Don't watch it with your children or your mom or whatever. Unless you don't care, then go ahead. Now, there's one scene where a man, the detective and some woman are about to have sex. And it's his birthday, I guess. We don't know. But there's a birthday cake with his name on it over here. And he picks it up and he just throws it on top of her. And then It was, and then he rubs us like, and I'm just like, maybe this guy's the killer. You know what I mean? Because that was a violent outburst. I said, maybe this guy's the killer, man.
Keep your woman in line.
Yes. And he kept smacking every woman in the film. You keep your woman in line. He was undercover. You remember? He was undercover in a Chinese restaurant, uh-huh, watching the guy that he thought was the killer, or he thinks is the killer, rather. And his wife is just berating him, you know, the suspect. And he breaks his cover to walk over to the man's wife and smack him two times. And then he turns to him and said, "You keep your woman in line." And then he said, "I was undercover watching you, but I broke my cover because I felt bad for you." It's just very weird. They don't talk like how normal people talk.
Yeah.
So, on a numerical scale, well, let's just say it was funny. I thought it was very funny. I was surprised. I wasn't expecting a funny movie, but it was very funny. It was not scary to me at all.
Yeah, no.
No. Some cool gore stuff, but really not a lot of killing either. Not a lot of murders. There is one in the shower scene where someone loses a carotid artery. So that happens, but on a numerical scale, I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10. Kevin, what do you think?
I enjoyed it, but I feel like I should be rougher than I want to be, because the plot is, there's no plot. And yeah. I mean, if you like a plot, and I do like me a good plot, I feel like you're going to be disappointed. Maybe if you look it up, there is a plot. It's just a weird movie. So for that reason, I mean, I'm pretty much with Max. I would say maybe a 7. Yeah. Just for the way it was shot, I did like that.
You're definitely going to be entertained, but he's right. There is no plot.
Yeah.
We don't even know what happened in the movie. I'm not sure at all. There's an ending, but there's not an ending.
Yeah. Well,
I don't know.
Yep.
We don't know. So there it is. The first impromptu review of, and today we did The Editor. Expect a couple more impromptu reviews in the near future, because everybody keeps parking so close to me, man. Like, I'm inside the line and they park on the other side of the yellow line like imbeciles. And there are spaces all over the place. They just choose to, park next to me. I guess I'm just friendly. But anyways, yo, expect more reviews, impromptu reviews from me and Kevin. We're going to be watching films that neither of us have seen before. Especially in the next 2 weeks, we're probably going to watch about 10 films together. We're going to review them all for you guys. And they could be old films, new films, horror films, comedy films, drama films, romance films, probably not.
And they seem to all be pretty weird, so that'll be interesting.
I'm thinking the next one we're going to do is Bad Ronald. I've seen that movie, but I've seen it like 8 years ago. But let me tell you something. That movie's amazing. Kevin, you're going to love it. It's a 1970-something TV movie. But anyways, guys, we'll catch you next time. We're going to go pick up the Chinese food because it should be ready.
Later.
I'm hungry too, man. Let's go eat.
Peace, bro.
Peace.